Okay, so today we'll discuss about the basics of algorithms. Very first, what is an algorithm? There is one simple and clear definition of the algorithm is an algorithm is a sequence of logically arranged, unambiguous instructions for solving a problem in a finite amount of time for a given input. There are few terms that we have to keep in our mind. First is the instructions are logically arranged. Second, the instructions are unambiguous. It means there is no ambiguity in the instruction itself. Otherwise, whenever we convert the algorithm to a program, then the machine will not be able to understand the instruction and is will not be able to execute that instruction. Next is a finite amount of time. It means every algorithm having finite number of steps to execute, such that the algorithm will terminate within a finite amount of time. And the algorithm also processes on a given input. So, for a given input, if the algorithm is correct, then we'll get the desired output, or we can say correct output. So, this is very simple definition of the algorithm. Now we discuss about the basic characteristics of the algorithms. Every algorithm having these five characteristics at least. One is finiteness, definiteness, input, output, and effectiveness. Now we'll discuss each and every characteristics in more detail. Like finiteness, it means the algorithm terminates after a finite number of steps. Okay. We cannot design algorithm in such a way that the algorithm continuously executing and will never stop. It means there are infinite number of steps. Okay. So algorithm should be designed in such a way that there are finite number of steps available and the algorithm will never go to a infinite loop. Second, definiteness. It means it is related with the instruction, whether instruction is unambiguous or it is ambiguous. Remember one thing, every instruction of the algorithm is unambiguous. There should be some clear and precise meaning of every instruction. There is no double meaning of the instruction, otherwise the machine will never understand the meaning of instruction and execute. It will report the error, even it will report the compile time error. What is input? Every algorithm must be supplied with some valid inputs, and these inputs are clearly specified. Inputs must be clearly specified. Otherwise, if inputs are incorrect, then output will be also incorrect. It means we will not get the desired output because the input is itself wrong. Okay, so inputs must be correct and clearly specified, then and only then we will get the correct output. Fourth is output. Every algorithm can produce correct output for a given input. Okay, output is also important because everything we are doing for the output only, right? So for a given input, the output must be correct. Last is effectiveness. It means the steps are sufficiently simple and basic. The algorithm must be written in a very precise, simple, and understandable form. Then we can say the algorithm is more effective. Okay? So the steps must be simple and basic. There is no complexity allowed. Now, when we are talking about the design of the algorithm, there are certain basic issues that we also have to think about. Issues, it means the challenges for the designing of the algorithms. Okay? So, very first challenge is how to design the algorithm. Okay? As a designer of the algorithm, this is the very basic and simple issue. How he or she can design the algorithm. Second is how to express the algorithm. The algorithm should be very finite number of steps. Each and every instruction must be unambiguous, clear, and simple. Okay, so any person can easily understand what the designer has written. What is the logic of the algorithm? Third is proving the correctness of the algorithms. Okay, because when we design an algorithm, then it is our sole responsibility to prove that for a given input, the algorithm generates the correct output. Okay, so proving the correctness of the algorithms. Fourth is efficiency. We also have to check the performance of the algorithm with the two type of the analysis, theoretical analysis and empirical analysis. Theoretical analysis, it means a kind of what you can say on paper or theory based analysis, and empirical, it means practical based analysis. Once theoretical analysis is identified, then the researcher or the designer of the algorithm should also test it on a practical basis. Then last one is optimality. Every algorithm must be optimal, but it is the matter of like necessity is the mother of invention. Then once one algorithm is designed which is more optimal, then the other researchers may work on the other approaches or may improve the existing algorithm which is giving more optimal solutions than the existing one. Okay, so research is always going for finding the different algorithms, designing the algorithms for a given problem. Next is analysis of the algorithms. How we can analyze the performance of the algorithm? There are two basic questions may arise in our mind. One is how good the algorithms are, and second is does there exist a better algorithm? So let's talk about the first question, that how good the algorithm. Okay, there are three measures to check the algorithm is good or not, because the comparison of among algorithms can only give us which algorithm is good. Okay, and there should be some comparison measures, some comparison parameters. Okay, so basically for analyzing and identifying the good algorithm, there are three parameters. One is correctness, time efficiency, and space efficiency. Correctness, it means the obviously every algorithm should give the desired output or correct output for a given input. So algorithm, very first, it must be correct. If it is correct, then we check its performance with respect to other two parameters, time efficiency and space efficiency. So time efficiency, it means how fast the algorithm gives the output. And space efficiency, it means how much time will be taken by the algorithm, how much space will be taken by the algorithm to process it. So let's start again. So every algorithm must be correct. It means for a given input, it should generate the desired output. If algorithm is correct, then we have to talk with the next parameter or the performance measure, which is time efficiency. It means we can only compare the performance of the algorithms with respect to the time effectiveness. We'll discuss about how one algorithm is better than the other algorithm with the time efficiency parameter, and Third is space efficiency. It means how much space will be utilized by the algorithm during the execution. So these are the three important measures by which we can say how the algorithm is good. Next question is, does there exist a better algorithm? The answer for this question is given with the help of these two parameters, lower bounds and optimality. Lower bound is mainly deal with the worst case performance of the algorithm. Whenever we are comparing the performance of the algorithm, then we can say one algorithm works more better or works faster than the other algorithm in a worst case. Then we can say first algorithm is good than the second algorithm. We will discuss more detail about the lower bounds, upper bounds, and average bounds. Next is optimality, that is whether one algorithm is more optimal than the other algorithm. Optimal in the form of whether it gives the result, more effective results or not,